So how did you move from physically exhausted and financially upside down to living your life by design in less than 10 years?
I think that in one word, it's pain. And I remember a time where the pain in my life was so great that anything was better than where I was. So I was exhausted in terms of it didn't matter how much I slept. I never woke up feeling rested. I was truly financially upside down. So every month it was like, what bill am I going to pay? How am I going to get through this? And I would lay in bed at night, cry and suffer. And really realizing that something had to change. And I got a call from a friend who started talking to me about opportunity and a company that she was looking at, to which I eventually said yes to. But this was the interesting thing, was as I went on this journey with this company to kind of bring my finances back right side up, I began to realize that I had put my health on the back burner. And so I had been taking care of everybody else except myself. So if anyone's listening to this, I imagine there's so many people that you put everybody else in front of you, but you don't take care of you. And my realization as I was crashing, that if I crashed, there would be no one who could do the things I did for my family. And I was the provider in many ways. And so that realization had me begin to decide that the first cup that I had to fill up was my own. And I had to begin to reclaim my physical and financial fitness. The second realization I had was that I could depend on an employer to give me a raise. I could depend on you know, climbing that proverbial ladder, but I had been doing that for 16, 17 years and still not where I was. And my aha was that no one, in the equation of trading time for dollars, no one was gonna pay me what I was worth. So I had to make a change again. And the real thing that I really wanna say as you're listening is that everything shifted when I took 100% responsibility for where my life was going. And it was a shift here, that I was 100% responsible for what was going well and what wasn't, where my finances was and where it was not, and it wasn't to anybody else to give it to me. And from that moment, I began planning and designing my life. I began living my life with intention. And so every day I started taking care of my health. So I filled my cup up every single day. I started planning my future in terms of creating great targets and goals around my money, around my career, around business, and just beginning to do my best to live into that plan. And have I hit every mark? No. But on my journey to that mark, I ended up further than I was without having that plan. And that became the shift. And so it started with small steps around my health, small steps around my wealth, small steps around stepping into entrepreneurship. And then you look up 10 years later and you go, how did I get here? Who is this person? Well, this person started with a decision to reclaim my physical and financial fitness. And that decision shifted into a mindset that I call, you know, I found my fantastic. I found that brilliance that lives within me. And in those two, I started feeling fulfilled. I started feeling confident in who I was. I started believing in me. And I started believing that anything I put my mind to could indeed be possible. And that began shift after shift after shift. And yes, I wake up where I am today, and I truly believe I am just beginning. However, when you look back 10 years, you go, wow, have I come a long way? One small step at a time. That's truly what it is.